What is up, you guys? This is Mini Superheroes Today.
Hey folks, Jonathan here, and I just had a great Lego haul from Facebook Marketplace. So let me take this mask off, because I wore it while I was out getting this stuff, and tell you a little bit about what I got today. So you can see some Indiana Jones, some Star Wars back there. But I got on Facebook Marketplace this morning and saw a haul, actually on OfferUp first, and then we were going to meet in a certain part of town, and then I saw something on Facebook Marketplace that was right nearby, so I figured, hey, I'm going to get it all in one swing, so let's take a look at what I got.
All right, so we're going to start on this side because this is actually the first part of the haul. So it's a big LEGO Dimensions collection. Now, most of this stuff is actually sealed. So we have the 2016 Female Ghostbusters story pack from LEGO Dimensions. We have the Fantastic Beasts story pack, all sealed, like I said. And then we have the Lego Batman movie story pack, which of course had Robin and Batgirl in it. So that's pretty cool. As far as the figures go, interestingly, none of those really had too many desirable figures. But we do have Slimer here from the Ghostbusters, sealed. Very rare figure. Speaking of rare figures, we have the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man and the Terror Dog here, which are pretty awesome. Again, sealed. Very, very rare there. Here we've got Hermione from Harry Potter. Not quite as rare, but still a good find. And then probably the least rare of them all is Tina Goldstein, which is a really cool figure, actually. That's the head I use on my Hope Van Dyne custom, but not exactly a rare figure. Then we have the player board here for LEGO Dimensions. That's not really valuable or anything like that. We've got this. And then we have the ones that have been opened. So we have the Beetlejuice LEGO Dimensions here. That's pretty cool. All complete, too. It's just, you know, doesn't have the box or whatever. Let's see. This one here appears to be sealed. This is the Joker and Harley Quinn LEGO Dimensions. Pretty rare, especially for that old Harley figure. Not super valuable, but it is rare. Here we've got the Harry Potter one. This is cool because this was before the Harry Potter theme relaunched for LEGO. So at the time, Harry Potter was a pretty rare LEGO figure, so pretty cool to get that. Let's see what else is in here. Now, this one is definitely the best part of the LEGO haul for the Dimensions haul, and that is Sonic the Hedgehog. This is really awesome. That Sonic minifigure is great, and once again, that's still sealed, so that's really cool. And then we've got the Ghostbusters with Venkman in here, and the cool thing about this Venkman is you could see he has some arm printing on there, like he's got the Ghostbusters patch printed on his arm, and this is still sealed, so that's really awesome. And then what else have we got in here? We've got the Gremlins, both Gremlins minifigures in there, complete. And then, these are just the regular LEGO Dimensions, so Batman, Gandalf, the Batmobile, and Lucy. And we've got one more here, and it's the Powerpuff Girls. So, actually, all three Powerpuff Girls. So that's the team pack and the individual pack, the level pack as well. So that's everything here, and all that LEGO Dimensions stuff was $100. The Sonic one alone is worth $40, so it's definitely a great deal and some really good stuff there. So moving over, let's move some of this Dimensions stuff. This stuff was part of the second haul, which I mentioned. So I went to these people's house, which unbelievably, they only lived a few minutes away from where I picked up all the Dimensions stuff. And initially, they were just selling this, is all I knew about, which, of course, you guys know I'm a big LEGO Indiana Jones fan. And even though I already have this, I was really excited because it was complete. But I showed up at their house, and it also had the box. So this set here was $50 complete. Great, great deal, especially considering I didn't have to pay the, you know, $15, $20 eBay shipping on top of a set that usually goes for $70 already. So to get this with the box is great. I'm going to guess this is probably worth about $100 to $150 plus shipping. So that's really awesome. Then they also had this police station, which is really cool. I actually don't have a police station in my LEGO City, so I was really excited for this. This was $50, and now this isn't quite as valuable as that. I do love that the front panel opens up. That's very cool, but I didn't have this one as a kid. I don't have any particular nostalgia for it, but it is a LEGO police station that I don't believe I've built yet. I've built most of them, but I haven't built this one, and it is complete, so this was $50 as well. So I said, hey, I see that you guys have these two LEGO sets. Do you have any more? And lo and behold, they actually did. So we've got this one here, which is the General Grievous Starfighter from the Clone Wars. And I actually, I'm trying to think if there's a way to do this one-handed on camera. They did throw some tape on the back of the boxes to keep it open like that. So let's see. I'll open this up because I want to show you something else that's in here. Yeah, there we go. You could see that there are some Mandalorian troopers in there from the Clone Wars Mandalorian Battle Pack. And I do have to show you guys one more thing, the best for last. I believe it's in this box, if I'm not mistaken. So there was one other thing when they had all these sets that they were going through. And I said, hey, would you throw this in too? So we negotiated. I'm sure you guys can see what it is. It is the Lego X-Men set. So I got the original Lego X-Men set from 2012. There's Deadpool in there. There's Wolverine. There's Magneto. And as if that isn't cool enough, it actually has the box with it too. So the box is in mint condition. It was amazing to find that. I was not expecting that. And you know, this is primarily a superheroes channel here, so you guys know how rare that Lego Deadpool figure is, let alone the whole set. So just if you guys are keeping track, I paid $50 for this. They said they would take $20 for this. They took $30 for this, plus the Mandalorian troopers, and $50 for this. So $150 for all of this stuff. Needless to say, it is a great deal. I mean, Deadpool alone is worth $50 on a good day. Usually more like $35, honestly. But sometimes he goes for $50. Just depends. But in any case, amazing, amazing haul today. So drop a comment below. Let me know if you guys have had any hauls recently with, like, yard sales coming back and all that. I'm always curious to hear what you guys are finding out there. And let me know what your favorite part of this haul was. All right. Thanks so much, guys. And I'll see you guys on the next video. If you liked what you saw and you liked what you heard, be sure to hit that subscribe button for more LEGO videos just like this one, and stay tuned for more awesome stuff coming on this channel. Thanks so much, and I'll see you guys on the next video.